Good morning, High Tides. This week we're bringing you a very earthy episode, and we're sinking down and getting up close and personal with the depths of the Scuba Club.
Scuba Club if you're looking for a fun and exciting way to spend time outside of school and meet some great people while participating in an activity that most people only dream of. But baby, tonight we're beautiful now. We're beautiful now. Scuba Club allows people to hang out with their friends, have a healthy activity, and expose you to new things that you may not have the chance to do otherwise. Joining this club does look good for colleges. It not only shows teamwork and an emphasis on safety, but we have some great dive programs at our local schools. Both UM and FIU have incredible dive research programs, so it'll definitely give you a leg up once you join those colleges. We meet for Scuba Club on campus every other Wednesday at opposite the Ecology Club. And when we do our in-water activities, we meet at Tarpon Lagoon Dive Center in the Miami Beach Marina. And our activities usually take place on weekends. Within the club, we're going to give you the opportunity to participate in a lot of activities and events that you can use towards community service. Coral reef restoration, seagrass mitigation, and fish surveys. If there are artificial reef systems and how successful they've been. And outside of that, anywhere you go in the world, you have the ability to dive for pleasure, especially with the Caribbean being so close, it's a nice option. You can come see me, I'm usually in room 266. Or Mr. Rehage in room 375.
Refreshing. A couple of weeks ago we had a code red, and we believe it's important to refresh you guys on the subject of a lockdown.
Don't worry kids, I'm Code Red Man, and I'm here to tell you how to handle the code red, man.
Well, first you need to turn off the lights, and then you need to lock the door, so a threat can't see you.
Get off your phone, idiot.
Good point. Remember, keep your brightness all the way down, and please, don't play music.
Wait, what are you guys doing?
Wait. Don't leave. You're not supposed to leave during a code red. Sit back down. Thank you, kids, for having me today. Thank you. I'm gonna go keep some kids safe now. Goodbye.
Stay safe, High Tides. Now let's focus on something more positive and talk about the most peaceful day on Earth.
September 21st is International Peace Day, and it celebrates the absence of violence all throughout the world. Our very own Shape Club and the Show Choir got the chance to go to a conference in the Government Center building and interact with fellow alumni and college professors to talk about methods to bring us closer to world peace. After that, they all gathered at a stage where people talked about accomplishments and acknowledgments from the previous year. Then the show choir started singing songs by Bob Dylan and John Lennon, speaking about peace and virtue throughout the world. But the show choir wasn't the only group that got to perform. We also got an excellent performance by a talented singer and a drummer.
We are honoring what the United Nations declared 34 years ago, that every year on September 21st would be a day of peace, internationally. It's agreed upon by several nations, one of which was in this hemisphere. And so ever since then, we've been, the community's been a little slow. Marjorie York made sure that Miami-Dade County was aware of the day, and she began a movement on Miami Beach. It started out very small, very few people, and now it has gone to the proportions that you saw today, where we have a few hundred people. And hopefully over time it's going to get even larger. There are many communities around the world that have very large events. Miami's still catching up. Okay. But hopefully we can spread this message of peace so we can hopefully reduce or even eliminate war. Not just war with weapons, but war with words. We just don't have a loving society anymore. That comes about from people making peace.
Hare Krishna. High Tides, have a great weekend.